born again. They hung Christ like an ornament. To the Lord, she only, he was sent. I ain't know who I was, so I had to repent. Why we in this condition? Cause we didn't follow and listen. You gotta be born again, and I'm on a mission. I don't wanna talk, pay attention, cause you in the midst of sin. I was born again.
Yes. Bring it out!
I'm going with that, Psalm 83 verse. Some people out here stupid as hell, man. I hear honest things, they know not what, man. Didn't most of God to say you worship, you know not what? Bring it out,
God.
This is the book of Psalm, chapter 83, and verse number 1.
Bring it out!
Keep not thou silence, oh God!
Do what?
Keep not thou silence, oh God!
But we're begging for the most high not to keep it silent. Why not?
Oh, hold not thy peace and be not still, oh God!
And we're asking the most high not to hold his peace, man. Right. Keep going.
For lo, thine enemies make it to more.
Thy who?
Thine enemies make it to more.
Now look around and look at all this goddamn wickedness around here, man.
Hey, everybody wanna celebrate this wicked ass Christmas holiday? And guess what? Sin ain't real.
Right.
People take straight to your face. Huh. Even going on your kids' holiday. Huh. Right? Sin ain't real. We know y'all the one buying your friends, y'all going to pick the tree. Christmas presents? Not knowing what? Sin ain't real!
Huh!
Keep going, King!
And they that hate thee have lifted up their head! They have taken crafty counsel against thy people!
They have done what?
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people!
All these wicked ass devils, they took a crafty counsel against us! And y'all so damn stupid that you don't even know it!
Right!
Alright, they say they're working hand in hand, they're figuring out ways to keep us at the damn bottom!
Right!
They to keep us to sin against our Father! Keep going!
And they ain't consulted against that hidden one.
We're the hidden one.
Right.
The so-called black, Hispanics, and Native Americans of Negro descent. We're the hidden ones. And we know this. And you are a so-called white man. We know you trickery. Keep going.
They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
What did they say?
Come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
And we know y'all came together and said, let's cut the Israelites off from being a nation.
Right.
God had a hand in it.
Right.
Keep going.
That the name of Israel may be no more.
That the name of who?
That the name of Israel shall be no more.
That the name of who?
That the name of Israel shall be no more.
Continue.
In remembrance, for they have consulted together with one consent.
Right.
They are confederate against thee.
They're what?
They are confederate against thee.
All you nations, the so-called white man, the East Indian man, the Chinese man, all y'all work together to come against me, my people. Y'all hate us. Always have. And we notice that we irritate your face. And we don't give a damn about your country.
Right.
We don't give a damn about your holidays.
Right.
Your holidays being sent to us.
Right.
Keep going, King.
Right. Verse 6. The tabernacles of Edom. And the Ishmaelites.
The who?
And the Ishmaelites.
Okay.
Of Boaz. And the Hagarene.
The Chinese.
The Gabal. And Ammon.
The African.
The Amalite.
The
Philistines, the
so-called Jews,
with the inhabitants of Tyre.
All y'all got a hand in our sit there and our fall.
Right.
And y'all see to continue to keep us at the bottom. Because y'all know y'all don't want no black man to rule over y'all.
Right.
And guess what? Christ is black, and he's coming back.
Right.
And he's going to be in charge of all of y'all.
Right.
And we're going to have him in rulership.
Right.
It was with Solomon chapter 2. Because you know what? We're going to let everybody know what the so-called white man, how y'all think. Y'all think y'all sleep. Y'all slick. We know y'all game. And y'all are nothing. Y'all nothing but spittle. And the most that's gonna destroy every last one of y'all. So-called white people.
This is the book of Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 2 and verse 5.
Bring it out!
For our time is the very shadow that passeth away.
This is what y'all think. That's why y'all trying to rule everything now.
And after our end, there is no returning.
See, the white man think that there's no, after they die, then everything is gone after that. They don't have to deal with it. They think they don't have to deal with the things that we've been through. Alright? Not that y'all can escape it. But y'all are fools. Continue on.
For it is fast sealed, so that no man cometh again. Come on, therefore. Let us enjoy the good things.
And look around us. They sit and come together and say, let us enjoy these good things. Ain't nothing good about Christmas. Christmas is a satanic holiday.
Right.
Alright, kids, y'all hear that? And still ain't real.
Right.
Sin is fake.
Santa is fake!
Santa is fake!
Continue on.
God, select us, and let us speedily use the creatures like us in youth. Let us fill ourselves with costly wine and ointments. and let no flower of the spring pass us by.
And see, that's how they carry it, man. They sit and walk through life. See, they got the money and the sit there and the connects. They sit there and they afford the things that they got. And see, they think they can live life to the fullest.
Right.
They can sit there, don't give a damn about the sit there, the earth itself.
Right.
They kill everything where they go.
Right.
They destroy everything where they
right.
go.
Right.
And we got, y'all are wicked ass people, man.
Bring it out.
Y'all destroy everything, man. I can't think of one thing that y'all don't destroy.
Right.
Y'all don't hunt down, that you don't kill, that you don't steal. Y'all do it all. And we know we can't stand your guts. We hate the so-called white man.
Right.
The so-called white man, the so-called white woman, and the so-called white child.
Right.
They're good.
Come.
They think y'all hate us.
Come.
You think we don't know y'all hate us.
Come.
Y'all say that y'all love it, but it's all filthy lies.
Continue on, King.
Come. Let us crown our sons with rosebuds before they be withered. Let none of us go without his hook right. of our voluptuousness.
See that? They said, let's not leave this place without sitting there getting everything that we want out of this place, man.
Right.
They really don't give a damn. They was all, and all y'all so damn stupid Israelites that y'all want to keep joining hand in hand with the wicked ass enemy, man.
Right.
Then they look at us like we crazy. They don't know the fear of the Lord.
Right.
Every other sit there nation that forgot who the Lord is.
Right.
But guess what? The so-called white woman, man, and child is
the
going
white
to slavery.
Woman is a goddamn devil.
You're right. going to slavery. All right. And you can make me and my brothers and our sisters at the finest lemonade. Alright? The finest fruit salad.
Right.
Y'all gonna be in our sitting there in slave fields. Our cotton fields. Continue on, King.
Let us leave tokens of our joyfulness.
Let us leave what?
Let us leave tokens
of our joyfulness. Fake ass snow globe.
Right.
Fake ass tree.
Right.
This fountain right here.
Right.
With the golden great bridge.
Right.
Doggone, what happened to the World Tower? Huh? The Twin Towers. And you know what? The Lord had them things come down. That was the Lord's doing. What's another one of their monuments that they talk about?
Mount Rushmore. Right.
Yeah, them on the Statue of Liberty.
Right.
I can't wait till I see that thing blow up into smithereens.
The Eiffel Tower.
The Eiffel Tower.
The Twin Towers.
And the Most High can bring all that down.
Right.
This country ain't nothing.
Right.
The U.S. debate and every other country that the so-called white man is in control of.
Right.
Most High will send his son down here with a fleet of angels and gonna bring all this down.
Bring it out.
Continue on, King.
Let us leave tokens of our joyfulness in every place.
Right.
For this is our portion and our lot is this.
That's right. And you know what? They won't lie about that part right there right quick, though. Give me the book of 2 Ezra chapter 9, verse 6.
Bring it up.
They said, for this, that's their portion. It ain't right.
Right
there right now is their portion. But you know what? Something is coming after that. We gonna be in rulership.
Right.
And the earth is gonna be ours forever after that.
That's right.
Bring that out.
This is the book of 2 Ezra chapter 9, in verse 6.
Bring it out.
Even so, the times also of the highest.
No. Give me
6
and
9. 6 and
9. Lock.
This is the book of 2nd Ezra, chapter 6, in verse 9.
Bring it out!
For Esau is the end of the world.
For what?
For Esau is the end of the world.
For the so-called white man is the end of the world. What next?
And Jacob is the beginning of it, the followers.
And we're the beginning of what is of that which is followers, man.
Right.
We're going to be in rulership.
Right.
Y'all going to be kissing our feet. Y'all going to be cleaning our floor.
Right.
Y'all going to be sitting cleaning our mansion.
Right.
We ain't got nothing else to worry about.
Right.
The hell with this wicked ass holiday.
Come.
Big ass L. Santa ain't real, son.
And all that?
Santa ain't real.
Santa is fake.
Santa ain't real.
Santa is
your mom,
fake.
Your mom and dad is the one that bring it by your
family. Santa is the devil.
Right.
Bring it out.
Bring the priest up.
Proverbs chapter 29 and verse 2.
Bring it out.
When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice.
With what?
When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice.
Hey, but ain't nobody that's righteous in authority right now.
Didn't
the book of Job say the hand is given into the earl is given into the hand of the wicked?
That's right.
The so-called white man is in charge right now.
Right.
And our people is mourning every day. I gotta wake up asking a prince of the Most High. Hoping that I don't get killed by the so-called white man.
Right.
Hoping that my sister or my brother don't get killed by the so-called white man.
Right.
They do it every day.
Right.
They slay us every day. The damn car light don't work. You get pulled over. You get a bullet in your head. You spit in the street, you get a bullet in your head. Hell, you can be in your old house sleep and you catch a bullet in your head.
Right.
Keep going.
But when the wicked grab fool, the people mourn.
And our people are mourning every day, man.
Right.
But you
right.
know what? Like I said, the Most High, the house. By Shimma Mashiach Yahweh Shai.
By Shimma Mashiach Yahweh Shai.
And we're going to be back on top.
Well, right.
It gets better, huh?
Keep going.
Verse 4. The king by judgment establishes the land.
You what?
The king by judgment establishes the land.
Right.
But he that receiveth gifts overthroweth it. He that what?
But he that receiveth gifts overthroweth it.
Look at it, man. Yeah. Look at so-called Santa, man.
Right.
Satan in the flesh. Look at that. Saint Nick, the damn devil.
The devil.
Damn Nimrod.
Santa ain't real. That's somebody in a costume.
Santa is not real.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 10, verse 2.
Right now.
Thus saith the Lord. Learn not the way of the heathen.
Do what?
Learn not the way of the heathen.
What is the way of the heathen?
And be not dismayed at the signs of heaven.
Keep going.
For the heathen are dismayed by them.
Look at all these heathens around us, man.
Look at
them. They are dismayed when they see the so-called fake-ass Santa Claus.
Right.
This fake-ass snow globe.
Right.
The fake-ass Christmas tree.
Right.
They're dismayed at these things.
Right.
And the Most High told us don't do the same thing.
Bring it on.
Learn not their ways. Keep going.
For the customs of the people are named.
For what?
For the customs of the people are named.
Every last thing out here that y'all celebrate is bidding.
Right.
Damn bidding to the Lord.
Right.
For one cutteth a tree out of the forest.
For one do what?
For one cutteth a tree out of the forest.
Right? The work of the hands of the workmen with the axe. They deck it with silver and with gold.
They do what?
They deck it with silver and with gold.
They deck the damn tree up with silver and gold. What else do they do?
They fasten it with nails.
They fasten it with nails.
And with hammers. That it move not.
That it what?
That it move not.
This so-called Christmas tree. Keep going.
They are upright as the palm tree, but speak not. They must needs be born, because they cannot go. Be not afraid of them.
Be what?
Be not afraid of them.
This so-called Christmas tree can't do a damn thing for us.
At all.
The Christmas tree can't get us out of captivity.
Right.
The Christmas tree can't help us pay our damn bills.
At all.
The Christmas tree can't do a damn thing for us.
Whoa.
Christ has to be in idolatry and to be against our God.
Whoa.
How you doing, brother? You doing all right, kid? What's your name, kid? Huh?
I go by AJ.
Nice to meet you, AJ. Alright, man, so what we are doing, man, is waking our people up, letting our people know that we are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of.
Right.
You heard about the situation with Kanye and Kyrie?
Yeah.
Well, they got bigger platforms, so just now really getting out there on a bigger scale, for real. But brothers been preaching this for years. And we are here to wake our people up, let our people know that we're the Israelites.
Right.
Alright, do you know anything about it?
Not at all.
Do you believe in the Bible, kid?
Yes.
You do?
Yes.
Alright, so who's in if you prove to you that we're Israelites according to the Bible, alright? Give me the book of Deuteronomy chapter 15.
This is the book
verse
of
28, verse 15.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28. Verse number 15.
Bring it out!
But it shall come to pass.
It says that it shall come to pass. Man, the story of Moses. Moses went to Pharaoh and said, let my people go. He's talking about a very specific people. And when Moses sit there, or when the Most High was working with Moses, he parted the Red Sea. And in doing so, when he led us out of Egypt, out of slavery, he told our people that the Most High God had gave us guidelines. You see, okay.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses
right.
shall come upon you and overtake you.
So, what Moses told the Israelites was, the Most High God told me to tell y'all that we have to keep all his laws. And basically, like a father, when a father tells his children to do something, if they don't do it, what happens? You get a whooping, right? That's what the Most High said. If y'all don't do what I told y'all to do, I'm gonna put these ass whoopings on y'all. Now we're gonna listen. We're gonna listen to some of these ass whoopings that the Most High put on our people. Give me verse 16.
Verse number 16. Cursed shall thou be in the city, and cursed shall ye be in the field.
Cursed shall thou be in the city. Now when you go to like Chirac or Detroit or Brooklyn, New York, Baton Rouge, our people is the ones that's sleeping on the sidewalks, strung out on drugs, begging for money, asking for welfare. Our people is the ones that's dealing with that. You agree?
Alright, and cursed shall thou be in the field. Look right here.
Our forefathers and mothers, brothers and sisters, was working in the tobacco field, sugar cane field. If I were to ask you what's your nationality, what would you say it is?
African American? That's a form of blinding. Why? Because African American comes from the name of two white men, Leo Scipio Africanus and America Vespucci. They conquered the lands and said that they named the lands after themselves. You get what I'm saying? You don't come from two white people, do you? Exactly. Or some of our people will say that they're black. Black is what you got on, is what I got on.
Right.
I'm not this color. We're different shades of brown. That's blinding. We don't know what's going on. If I was to ask you what the three rainbow mean, what would you say?
A lot of people will say that it means the letter community, LGBTQ, and so on. But it's really talking about the rainbow. Rainbow really represents the promise that God has made with us, that he will never flood the earth again.
Right.
You can find that in the book of Genesis, chapter 12. And astonishment of heart. Astonishment is sitting there in confusion. Our man is now coming out saying, I think I'm a female. But you're a whole man. How the hell you think you're a female?
Right.
You're a man. You were born with male parts. That's confusion. Give me Genesis chapter 9. The rainbow is in Genesis chapter 9. Give me verse 48.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse number 48.
Bring it out.
Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
The Lord said that we will have to serve our enemies.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
Which he shall send against us.
In hunger.
In hunger. So if you want to go somewhere like Ruth Chris, Cantina, Burrito, Mexican restaurant. Who's the CEO of these companies? What nationality is the CEO more than likely? Exactly. But remember, the Most High said we have to serve our enemies, right? And hunger. So you can franchise your way into McDonald's or some of these other companies. But remember, the CEO, 9 times out of 10, is a so-called white man. And I say so-called white man because that's not his real name. His real name would be Esau or Edom. Continue on.
And in thirst.
And it water comes freely out of the sky, coming out of natural springs out of the ground. They put it in a bottle, they charge you for it. We have to go to our enemies to sit there to pay for water. Velcro, to sit there, you gotta pay to wash your clothes. They charge you to sit there that a water bill, to sit just to have running water in your house. Continue on.
And in nakedness.
Remember, I told you earlier, we pay all the goddamn cotton. How come we don't have no textile mill? You get what I'm saying? So far, you can tell that the people that he's talking to that's dealing with this will be the so-called black, right? Continue on.
And in want of all things.
And in want of all things. You want to get a driver's license, a college education, a business loan, a business license, anything you want, a car. You got to go to the so-called white man to receive it. And remember, once again, the Lord said that that's your enemy. And want all things.
And he shall put a yoke around your neck.
And he shall what?
And he shall put a yoke around thy neck.
Who had your spine on in that, brother? It was us, wasn't it? See that? Look right here. And that's when the jingle bells come in there too. Jingle bells really started when they sit there and put the yoke of iron around our neck and they would put bells on it. So when you try to run, the bells will be jingling the whole time. So the dogs and all them will trail you. And another reason they had it, the yoke of iron so big, if you had a yoke of iron that big around your neck right there, would you run down a road or would you run in between the trees and whatnot if you're trying to get away from slavery? Now, the thing about that is, if you ran in between the trees with that yoke of iron on your neck, if that thing snagged on a tree, it would snap your neck immediately. Why? Because they'd rather you be a dead nigga than a free nigga. That's how they feel about it. They still do. Right now, they got a lot of smoking mirrors going on. But we're going to get to that for you.
Give me 54.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse number 54.
Bring it out!
You ever asked yourself why, brother, why people are killing each other so much? You ever asked yourself why your people are killing each other so much? You ever get an answer inside a church? The pastor ever tell you why people do it? Read that.
So that the man that is tender among you and very delicate.
Now, in the days of old, even sit there in the golden time of Martin Luther King, we was real tender and delicate amongst each other. I see, hey, brother, how you doing? How your family doing? You need anything? You know what I'm saying? Straight? And we will be able to converse, no issues. You try to do that with a brother now, they look at you up and down, they rude to you. Our brothers know, but you don't see that now. What should happen?
His eyes shall be evil toward his brother.
His what?
His eyes shall be evil toward his brother.
His eyes shall be evil toward his brother. Our brothers see to hate one another, black on black crime. You make a mistake and step in another brother's shoe, brother ready to gun you down. You look at a brother the wrong, you glance at a brother, he say, oh, you looking at me the wrong way, now they ready to fight. You see what I'm saying? It's one of the curses that the Most High God said they will put my people.
And toward the wife of his bosom.
And toward the wife of his bosom. Domestic violence. Who knows if it's in their hands on their woman that goes right now? What race of people? See?
And toward the remnant of his children, which he shall leave.
And toward the remnant of his children, which he shall leave. Who knows if it's leaving their children the most right now? Huh? White? White man ain't leaving their family like that. I know quite a few brothers that sit there that don't know their father. I know white people that know their father that sit there in black. The Indian man ain't leaving their children. The Chinese man not leaving their children. It's our brothers that's leaving their children, leaving their household.
Right.
Our people's the ones that's going through this thing on a greater scale anyway. Give me 68.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28.
Ain't gonna hold you up,
verse 68.
Bring it out.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
The Lord will what?
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Egypt is similar to Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 12. Egypt is being slavery and removed to.
It's the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6 and verse number 12.
Bring it out!
Then beware, lest thou forget the Lord, which brought thee forth out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage.
From the house of bondage. Bondage is being slavery. So now, see there, we'll replace Egypt with slavery.
And the Lord shall bring thee into slavery again.
You know how we got here to the USA? Watch this.
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
Did you know that was in the Bible? Yeah. You knew that part was in the Bible.
Come on.
All right,
Mosa.
Thou shalt by the way whereof I speak unto ye, thou shalt see it no more again.
Same way that Mosa God said it's gonna happen, it's gonna happen.
And there ye shall be sold.
And what?
And there ye shall be sold.
I mean, as soon as you get off them slave ships, you will be sold.
Unto your enemies.
Unto who?
Unto your enemies.
To your enemies. Who sold us as soon as we came off the slave ship? Huh? Okay, so-called white people. That's right. The Europeans.
Right.
And what did the Lord call them, though?
Called them our enemies. For bond men.
For slave men.
And for bond women.
And slave women.
And no man shall buy you.
No man shall buy you. Nobody's going to be able to redeem you. Because in the days of old, when our brothers were going to slavery, if you was a slaver, I would be able to come to your slave owner and buy you back out.
Right.
But the Most High God stretched his hand forth against us, and there's nothing we can do about it. So if breaking his commandments got us sitting over here, what must we do to go back home? If breaking his commandments got us sitting, that's right, brother. That's right, King. That's right, brother. Right. We got to go ahead and keep the commandments.
Huh.
Now,
Our whole generation is built by breaking those commandments.
But you know what? That's why we out here. Because we out here telling our brothers and sisters to repent and stop breaking the commandments so we can get up out of here.
Right.
So we can go back home, King. You understand? We ready to get up. We ready to get up out of here, man.
Good.
You get what I'm saying?
Right.
Now let me get give me Revelations 1. You know Christ is a so-called black man?
Bring it out.
Did you know that? You did know that?
Huh, good.
Alright, this is the book of Revelation. After that, I'm gonna give you a couple of laws. Then I'm gonna let you go, alright, King?
All right. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 13.
Bring it out!
In the midst of the verse 1.
Bring it out.
The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave unto him.
This is how Christ really looked. This is how Christ really looked.
To show unto his servants things which must surely come to pass. Verse 13.
Bring it out.
In the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man.
Right.
Clothed with a garment down to his foot.
Hey, Christ had a garment down to the foot.
Right.
And he had his fringes on.
Right.
Come on.
And girt about the peps with the golden girdle.
With a big golden girdle on. It like look like a wrestling belt.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
What was Christ's hair looking like?
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Hey, Christ's hairs was white like wool.
Right.
This guy right here don't got no white woolly hair.
Right.
He got that stringy doggy hair.
Right.
I don't see no woolly hair on this guy right here.
At all.
That's strike one.
Right.
Keep going.
As white as snow.
As what?
As white as snow.
As white as snow. His hair ain't white.
Right.
His hair is brown.
Right.
That's strike two.
And his eyes were a flame of fire.
His what?
And his eyes were a flame of fire.
Man, I see some blue eyes right here on this one right here. That's another strike, ain't it?
Right.
Keep going.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
What did his skin look like?
His feet like unto fine brass.
Hey, Christ had some dark feet, man.
Right.
Let's see how dark Christ's feet really was.
Bring it out.
As if they burned in a furnace.
As what?
As if they burned in a furnace.
Hey, Christ was so dark, it looked like he got burned in a furnace.
Right.
So if Christ was a so-called black man of dark complexion, who the hell is this guy right here?
The damn devil.
Who is he?
The damn devil.
He's a damn nobody.
Right.
Fake Christ.
Right.
So-called white man ain't nobody.
Right.
You see that, King? This is so-called white man. This is not how Christ really look, man.
You and that Christmas.
Right. That's somebody gay.
He's a damn faggot, man. Homosexual, man.
That's boy. Now, let me give you a few laws right here. Quick, man. Give me the book of Leviticus, chapter 11, verse number 7. Give me number 15, King.
Bring it out! This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 11. In verse number 7.
Bring it out!
Salakia. It's the book of Leviticus, chapter 11, verse 7.
Bring it out.
And the swine.
And the what?
And the swine.
This filthy-ass pork sandwich.
Though he divide the hoof and be cloven-footed,
right?
Yet he cheweth not the cud,
right?
He is unclean to you.
Now you hear that? The pig is unclean to us, King.
Right.
That's what we eat, pork. No type of pork. Pork chops, bacon, pulled barbecue, ribs. No don't touch none of that. The Most High said he's unclean to us. Keep on.
Of their flesh shall you not eat, and their carcass shall you not touch. They are unclean to you.
Can't even touch a dead pig.
Right.
They so filthy. First off, they have no sweat glands. So everything that they take in, they can't get rid of that bacteria out of their body. Then they sit there, they garbage disposed. They eat anything. Humans, feces, all of that. It's scientifically proven that they sit there, that those that eat pork got worms in their brain.
Right.
They treat their kids diseases like gout, high blood pressure, hypertension, all sorts of diseases from eating pork, man. It may taste good, but you're killing yourself. I mean, if you eat pork, that's just about as bad as smoking a cigarette.
Right.
Did you know that? See? Let's see what you can eat in the waters.
Bert, this is the book of Leviticus chapter 11, verse number
9.
Number 9.
Bring it out!
These shall ye eat of all that are in the waters.
Right.
Whatsoever hath fins and scales in the waters.
Right.
And in the seas and in the rivers, them shall ye eat. And all that have not fins nor scales in the seas and in the rivers, of all that move in the waters, and of anything that which is in the waters, They shall be an abomination unto you.
They shall what?
They shall be an abomination unto you.
So if you want to eat something that comes out of the water, the rivers, the sea, the ocean, what can you eat?
It has to have what?
It has to have fins and scales. So the only thing that you can eat that comes out of the ocean, rivers, and seas is fish. You can only eat fish, King.
Right.
And sit there by that man and say the thing, you can't sit there and eat no shrimp, crab, lobster. It's no good for you. The same thing that pigs do in the earth, they do in the ocean. That's why the ocean is dark and muddy now. You can't eat catfish because they got fins, but they don't have no scales. You can't eat that stuff, King. It's not good for you. All right? Now, one more law, then I'm going to let you go. All right?
Come. This the book of This the book of Numbers, chapter 15 and verse 38.
Bring it out.
Speak unto the children of Israel,
right?
And bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments.
So, you know, brothers got coats on, but you can both see both brothers. Brothers got fringes on, right? Those are the fringes we got to do. This is what we got to wear on our at the bottom of our shirt. See you on?
Throughout their generation.
We're still generating. We're still populating. Right. So therefore, you gotta rock your fringes.
And that they put upon the fringe at the borders a ribbon of blue.
A what?
A ribbon of blue.
Now, regardless of what color fringe we have, I got black and gray. He got gold. You know, he got silver and gray too. You can rock whatever color fringe you want. But we all got the same thing in common. You gotta have that ribbon of blue.
Right.
Yeah, it don't have to be a specific blue. It can be navy blue, baby blue. As long as you got a ribbon of blue, you keep the commandment, King.
Right.
All right? Why should we do a continue on, King?
And it shall be unto you for a fringe, that you may look upon it and remember all the commandments of the Lord and do them.
And do what?
And do them.
So this is a reminder for us to know that we're Israelites. We're better than everybody else. Give me the book of Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. And sit there, and we got to keep the Most High commandments.
Right.
You might be thinking about, man, damn, I want to smoke a cigarette. Look, damn, I'm an Israelite. I can't do that.
Right.
Damn, that doggone barbecue pork look good. Damn, you know, I'm better than that.
Right.
That's unclean to me. I can't eat that.
Right.
I'm royalty. That's what you are walking this earth, King.
Right.
You're royalty walking this earth.
Right.
And there's a kingdom that's waiting for you.
That's right.
So when we leave, man, and the head of the kingdom of the Most High, everything will be mapped up, set up for you, King. You ain't got to worry about working and sitting there to pay bills no more. You can sit there and have slaves working for you then. This the last scripture, then I'm going to go. There's more than that? Finish it off.
Come.
And do this. And that ye seek not after your own heart and your own eyes, after which ye used to go a whoring.
You can't sit there seeking after your own vanity thing that you want to do. You need to go back to keeping the thing that the Most High Father wanted us to do. Bring this out.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verse 6.
Bring it out!
For thou art a holy people.
We are holy people, man. Like I said, we want to. Holy means separate. If you got your favorite toy out of your toy box, what do the rest of the toys mean to you? Exactly. That's how it is with us to the Most High God. He created 18 different nations. But when he created us, all the other nations didn't mean a damn thing to him.
Right.
Because he chose us separately from everybody else.
Right.
He pushed all the other nations off the table and put us in front of him.
Right.
But thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
Who did he choose the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans to be?
To be a special people unto himself.
And the Most High God chose us.
That's right.
Above all people.
Above just the so-called white man.
Above all people.
Just the Chinese man.
Above all people.
Just the East Indian man.
Above all people.
And we're better than all y'all other nations out here.
That's right.
We're royalty out here.
That's right.
That's why our women look the best.
That's right.
That's why we cook the best.
That's right.
That's why we dress the best.
Right.
All y'all so-called nation want to be like the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Right.
That are upon the face of the earth.
That are upon the face of the earth, man. We better than everybody, man.
Right.
And I want you to keep that in your mind, man. Or walk around with your chest up. Sit there and know that you want to walk this earth, man. The brother give you a flyer.
Yeah.
Scan the QR code. The information that we provide with you up there, have a notebook and a pen. I encourage you that all the information that we provide you with, you look it up for yourself. And you'll see that the things that we bring out is true, alright, King? Alright, it's AJ.
Yes.
Alright, y'all are blessed, AJ, man. Love you, brother.
Y'all are
safe out here, King.
I want to see you out here again.
Yeah, definitely would like to see you out here again, King. We need more soldiers out here. We need brothers out here with us. So we can get the hell up out of here.
God.
Because what we're doing is our job is to seal the elect. Once the elect gets sealed, the Most High is going to see them close the door of repentance, and he's going to kill everybody else that didn't want to listen.
That's right.
So he's going to beat us up from out of here, all right?
God.
Come on. Shalom, brother. And with that, I'm going to let the next mighty and powerful speaker come up. I'd like to say shalom.
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 Get up from this right here. You don't mind? You want to get a word? I got one.
All right. I'm looking for somebody who's in the Christmas spirit. All you people come up here. Clearly y'all in the Christmas spirit. So let's talk. What are y'all here for? What is Christmas about?
Bring it out.
Is it about a guy in a snow globe? With a yo-yo? Is it about a deer called Bambi? Is it about Santa Claus and his ugly wife?
Right.
What's it about?
Right.
Is it about the white Jesus?
I'm
just curious. What are y'all in the Christmas spirit for?
Right.
I got $100 for one person who can prove that Jesus Christ is a white man.
Right.
$100 to one person who can prove that Jesus Christ was a white man.
Right.
Any takers? Any takers? Okay. Give me Revelation 1:13. Let's ruin our Christmas real quick. All right?
Give me Daniel 9:7.
Let's find out who the real Jesus is.
Right.
Alright?
Let's talk about it.
Revelation chapter 1.
So verse 1.
And verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The revelation of who?
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
Verse 13.
Verse 13. And in the middle of the seven candlesticks,
rule your scripture
like unto the Son of Man.
Oh, come, let's talk. Let's talk. Let's talk. Let's talk. Let's talk. I want $100 if you can prove this is in the Bible. $100.
I think you use $100.
Same as he looked at.
$100 if you can. I thought so.
Bring it out.
Bring it out.
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 13.
Bring it out.
And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the foot, and girt about the breast with a girding girdle. His head and his hair were white like wool.
What color was his hair?
His head and his hair were white like wool, as white as snow.
Does this man look like he has white woolly hair?
Nuh-uh.
Strike one. Bring it out.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
And what?
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Next verse.
And his feet like unto fine bread.
What color was it?
And his feet like unto fine bread.
Was it like porcelain white?
And his feet like unto fine bread.
Did it look like this white woman right here?
And his feet like unto fine bread.
Let's find out how dark Jesus Christ was.
As if they burned in a furnace.
How dark was Jesus Christ?
As if they burned in a furnace.
That's right. I want to ruin your Christmas. Jesus Christ is a black man.
That's right.
He hates all of you.
That's right.
Alright, give me Daniel to the church.
This is Daniel, chapter 10, in verse 4.
Bring it out.
Then I lifted up my eyes, and looked, and behold, a certain man clothed in linen, whose loins were girded with fine gold of ephod. The same description that we get in Revelation chapter 1:13. Bring it out.
His body also was like the barrel.
He was wearing a green garment.
Right. In his face as the appearance of lightning.
Keep reading.
His eyes as lamps of fire.
Just like what we read in Revelation 1:13. Keep reading.
In his arms and his feet.
And his what?
In his arms and his feet.
Let's find out what color the real Jesus was.
Right.
Like in color.
Like what?
Like in color. To polish brass.
that polished brass means a burnt brass, burned in a furnace.
Right.
So the real Jesus Christ that exists, the real Jesus Christ that you don't know, looks like us.
Right.
Not like you. The second question I have for all of you, who is the kingdom of heaven for? One person.
Step up. Step up. Prove it. Prove it from the Bible. Prove it from the Bible. Prove it from the Bible. I can prove to you that he hates you and your daughter. I can prove from the Bible that he
comes up to me. You just said that to a 7-year-old.
I said
that is fake.
Santa is fake!
Santa is fake! Santa is fake! Santa is fake!
Santa is fake! Alright, give me a...
Let's get Matthew chapter 24, verse 14. Let's talk about it then. Let's talk about it. Matthew 24, 14. Matthew 24, 32.
This one, wait, this is Matthew chapter 24 and verse 14. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations. And then shall the end come.
We are here to declare the end of your kingdom.
Right.
The end of the rule of the white man.
Right.
After this thing is done, the white man will no longer rule again.
Right.
We are at the end of days.
Right.
While you waste your time celebrating Christmas, worshiping the white Jesus,
right,
this country is falling apart.
Right.
Unless you want to die with this country, repent and come back to the Lord.
Right.
Give me Matthew 24, verse 32.
Bring it up.
Matthew chapter 24, verse 32. Now, learn a parable of the fig tree. When his branch is yet tender and putteth forth leaves, ye know that summer is high. Like ye know that summer is not enough.
What is that branch? Repeat that one more time.
Now, learn a parable of the fig tree.
The fig tree.
Right. When his branch is yet tender and putteth forth leaves, ye know that summer is nigh.
What does this mean? What is the fig tree? Let's find out. Jeremiah 8:13.
Jeremiah chapter 8 and verse 13. I will surely consume them, saith the Lord. There shall be no grapes on the vine, nor figs on the fig tree, and the leaf shall fade, and the things that I have given them shall pass away from them.
For the last 2,000 years, the Lord has consumed Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. He's brought us low. He's brought us to the bottom of American society,
right,
the bottom of European society, beneath these white people that we call Edomites.
Right.
He destroyed us because we broke his law.
Right.
But let's also see what's going to happen next. Give me Joel 1 and 7. I want to confirm that we are the fig tree. Joel 1 and 7. We are here to signal the end of the white man's kingdom. Enjoy your time now because it's almost over.
That's right.
201 and 7. We're here to declare the end of your kingdom. The end of American rule. The end of white supremacy. 201 and 7.
Bring it
out!
No worries,
no
worries.
This is Joel! Chapter 1 and verse 7.
Bring it out.
He have laid my vine waste.
The Lord has laid the Blacks and Hispanics and Native Americans waste. Keep going.
And burnt my fig tree. He have made it clean, bare, and cast it away.
Huh.
The branches thereof are made white.
He broke us down. He brought us low because he broke his commandments. But let's see what's about to happen. Give me Song of Solomon chapter 2:13.
Song of Solomon chapter 2 and verse 13.
Yeah. Brother, do you know your initial life? What's your nationality? Let me ask you. What do you call yourself? If you were filing for an application, what would you put down? So I had a job for you, right? I had a job. And I had certain races down on a piece of paper. Which race would you click? American, okay? That's what you would put down on the job application. Black, Asian, white, Hispanic. So everything we're about to read is for one specific group of people, the Israelites. Okay? It pertains to them.
Deuteronomy 29:1.
Bring it up.
These are the words of the covenant which the Lord commanded Moses to make with the children of Israel.
Deuteronomy
28 and verse 15.
Bring it up.
But it shall come to pass, if thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
If
thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So the Lord is saying, I'm going to make a contract with the Israelites. If they don't keep these commandments, I'm going to bring the following curses on them. Okay? Now let's read some of these curses.
Verse 16. Cursed shalt thou be in the city, and cursed shalt thou be in the field.
Now, what does this sound like? Let's think back to history, right? Of so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. Were we not cursed in the field in the 1600s, in the 1400s, right? The people lost their reservations, right? They were kicked off the reservation, right? Correction. They were kicked off their land and sent to reservation. Am I right? The Trail of Tears, right? Under Andrew Jackson. Remember that? Okay. Next part.
Yeah.
Cursed in the city and cursed in the field. We're cursed in the city, right? Go to every ghetto. Where are we at? At the bottom. Slum. Hispanics. Bottom. Slum. Native Americans at the reservations. Just destitute. Alcoholics. Done. Verse 30.
Thou shalt betroth the wife.
Thou shalt betroth the wife.
And another man shall lie with her.
And another man shall lie with her. What happened to Pocahontas?
I ain't know that much.
You don't know the story about Pocahontas? Well, you do your research. I want you to go home and do some research. A white man called, I think his name was
John Smith.
John Brown?
Smith.
Smith? John Smith? He saw this woman who already had a husband. And he said, I want that beautiful woman. And he took her. And he raped her. And when she fought back, she killed him. She killed her and her husband. Do your research, right? He killed her and her husband. Okay, you understand? Verse 32.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people, and thine eyes shall look and smell with longing for them all that they long, and there shall be no might in thy hand.
What does that sound like? Your sons and your daughters will be given to another people. What does that sound like?
That's it. Verse 32, thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
So one more time. I can't hear you, brother. Okay, they will be given unto another people. Slavery. In slavery. We have any slave signs of, if you've seen the slave movie, right? If Master Johnson wants to buy your little daughter or your little son, right? So, plantation days, Master Johnson can sell your son, and there's nothing you can do about it. 12 years a slave, it shows this. Roots, it shows this. The master can sell your daughter, your son, you couldn't do anything about it, to another plantation, and you would never see your child again. Alright? That's the fulfillment of that prophecy. Understand? This is happening to what people? But what do they call, what the Bible call?
Wake them up!
Remember what I told you were? These are the Israelites that God is talking to.
Alright,
okay? So let's get some more curses.
Verse 37.
Bring it out.
And thou shalt become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword among all nations. whither the Lord shall lead.
You shall become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword amongst all people. Nigga, spit, redneck. Right? What are some of the words they call Native Americans? They call them niggas? Okay, alright. But you get the point, right? Am I right? Am I wrong?
No, you're right. But I'm talking about
what's the Native American foul word, the slang? What's the bad word they call Native Americans? They got a word for myself, I'm sure. Very niggas probably. Who knows? Why people come up with all types of names?
This is Isaiah chapter 65 and verse 15.
Bring it out.
And ye shall leave your name for a curse unto my chosen. For the Lord God shall slay thee and call his servants by another name.
It's a byword. Call his servants by another name. So instead of being called an Israelite from the tribe of Gad, they're going to call you Native American or Indian, right, which is savage. It means savage, right? So now let's go back to verse 27. Verse
48. Therefore shalt thou serve thy enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee, in hunger, and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in want of all things.
You get that? We're going to have to serve our enemies. If hunger, anytime you need something to eat, you got to go to who? Your enemy, right? We were on the plantation. We had to ask the master for food, right? For water. We had to ask the master for water. Today, we want water. You can't go to your backyard and dip some out the well. You gotta go get what? Aquafina, right?
Right.
You gotta go get your tap water. Pay, you may not know this, but you pay a monthly fee for water. You know this? On your bill, utilities is water. So you gotta pay your enemy for water, for food, for clothes. Give me 49.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
Put a yoke of iron upon your neck.
Until he have destroyed
thee. Now, the yokes have come off. We're not walking around with yokes anymore. Why? Because we're mentally destroyed. When you have a dog, and you walk your dog around, at first you put a leash on that dog, right? But at a certain point in time, after you train that dog, what do? You take the leash off, take the yokes off.
Right.
At that point, you get a good slave. I don't need to tell you not to run away again. Because you're dependent upon me for everything. You see?
The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far, from the end of the earth, as swift as the eagle flying.
Now, this is a cryptic message here. The Lord is going to send a nation against you from a long way away, afar. As swift as the eagle flies.
Right.
Who came to oppress your ancestors? What nations came to enslave your ancestors? Columbus. What was his nation? What was his plan? Where did he come from? Christopher Columbus, right? Cristobal Columbus. Cristobal is what? Spanish, right? So now, what's the Spanish flag's, what's the Spanish logo? On the Spanish flag is what? What symbol? It's an eagle. It's an eagle. So if you go back and read the scripture again, it's going to say he's going to send a nation against you from afar as swift as the eagle flies. Spain, symbol was the eagle, right? Now let's see what else happens after that.
The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from afar, from the end of the earth, as swift as the eagle flies. A nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand.
When Christopher Columbus came here,
right? When Francisco Pizarro came here, they spoke Spanish. The natives didn't speak Spanish, did they? They spoke some other language, correct? The Bible has prophesied that they will come against you from afar. Their logo, their symbol will be the eagle, and they will speak a language that you wouldn't understand. That was written 4,000 years ago. You see the power in that? Now, let's keep reading. Now she's calling the cops, I know. But that's okay, because you can't move us off this block. Let's keep it moving.
A nation of fierce countenance, which shall not regard the person of the old, nor show favor to the young.
So they didn't give respect to them. They didn't give respect to the kids.
Verse 22. And he shall besiege thee and all thy gates until thy high and fenced walls come down.
So they came against us in military formation. Destroy our defenses.
Verse 4. So that the man that is tender among you and very delicate, his eyes shall be evil toward his brother.
His eyes shall be what?
His eyes shall be evil toward his brother.
What does this sound like to you?
So that the man that is tender among you,
man that's tender among you, my brother, I'm supposed to be tender with you. I'm supposed to be respectful with you. I'm supposed to prefer you, right?
But and very delicate, his eye shall be evil toward his brother.
But instead of showing you love, I'm showing you. What's that sound like today? Black on black crime. Black on black jealousy.
And toward the wife of his bosom.
And your wife? We have the stereotype of being against our brother and our wife. That's the stereotype, right? And what else?
And toward the remnant of his children, which he shall leave.
Which he shall do what?
Which he shall leave.
Who does that sound like? They say that black men leave their children. Is that what they say?
Right.
We're changing that, but that's the stereotype on us. Is that not correct? Prophecy written 4,000 years ago about the Israelites.
Right.
All these are curses to identify. Give me my 46.
And they shall be upon thee for a sign.
These curses are going to be upon you for a sign.
And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder, and upon thy seed forever.
Forever. So, what's the sign doing? What does the sign do? Like, if I look at this sign here, what does that sign, what's it there for? To let people know that that place is that place, right? These curses are going to be on the Israelites, Blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, to let everyone know who the Israelites are. Understand that, right?
Verse 68, and the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Somebody give me Exodus chapter 23.
Exodus chapter 20 and verse 2. I am the Lord thy God, which I brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
I am the Lord thy God that has brought thee out of that. Land of Egypt, aka the house of bondage. What's another word for bondage? Slavery, right? Remember, Egypt means slavery.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
He's going to bring you into slavery again. How do we get here? From West Africa. How did blacks get from West Africa? Slave ship, right? A boat. Now, maybe you didn't know this, but I'm going to tell you. Native Americans were sent to Europe on slave ships. Did you know that? All right. Mexicans, the Mayans, they were sent to Europe on slave ships. These curses fit our people, the Israelites.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. and there ye shall be sold.
We're going to be what?
And there ye shall be sold.
We got off those folks. It says sold.
Unto your enemy.
Unto our friends.
Unto your enemy.
Unto our best buddies.
And to your enemy. For by men.
Slave them.
And by women.
Yes, slave women.
And no man shall buy you.
That word means to redeem. So, who are your enemies according to that scripture? You can't hear you, brother. Say one more time, brother. They said we're going to be sold to our enemies. Who are we sold to?
Right.
So who was our enemy? That's right. Give me Sirach 6 and 13, please. Brother Kishar. Sirach 6 and 13, Brother Kishar. And the other person, give me Sirach chapter 12 and verse 10. Brother Kishar.
This is Sirach chapter 6. In verse 13,
no.
Separate thyself from thy enemies.
Be best buddies with them.
Separate thyself from thy enemies.
Have a friend you're going to have drinks with.
Separate thyself from thy enemies and take heed of thy friends.
God is telling you, he knows the right thing. He knows his inner thoughts. He says, get away from your enemies. Have you ever heard the stories of a black person who thought their best friend was a white person until they got hung on a tree? Until they were drowned in the pool? There's plenty of stories out there. Trust me. Give me Sirach 12 and 10.
Sirach chapter 12 and verse 10.
Bring it out.
Never trust thine enemy.
Do what?
Never trust thine enemy.
Never trust the so-called white man. Why?
For like as I'm resting, so is his wickedness.
Sure, he smiles like he cares about you, he loves you. But if you look a little closer and wipe off a little bit, you're going to see what?
Bring it out, brother. So as I'm resting, so is his wickedness.
His wickedness is going to show forth. So the first month, he may act like a good guy. He may buy you drinks. He may mow your lawn. Okay? But one day when you make him mad, that first time you make a man, he's going to say, you nigger.
Right.
And then he's going to look at himself, why did I say, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to say that. It's deep down, the wickedness is deep down within. They try to hide it, but it's always there. And when you see it, it's too late. Keep showing. Though he humbles himself.
And go crouching.
He'll crouch, he'll shake your hand. Brother. No, don't do this. I want to help you. I love you, brother. What happens?
Yeah, take good heed and beware of him.
Beware of him.
And thou shalt be unto him as if thou had his wife a looking glass. And thou shalt know that his trust, that his lust have not been altogether wiped away.
There's no possible way that a so-called white person will ever love you. There's always a seed of wickedness in it. All right, let's get to the man. Give me Leviticus 11 and 7. Give me, please, Exodus 20 and 8.
Leviticus 11 and verse 7.
Where it is.
Verse 1, and the Lord spake unto Moses and to Aaron, saying unto them, speak unto the children of Israel, saying, these are the beasts which ye shall eat among all the beasts that are in the earth. Verse 7. And the swine.
And the what?
And the swine. Though he divide the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he too is not the good. He is unclean to you.
He's what?
He is unclean to you. Of their flesh ye shall not eat, and their carcass shall ye not touch.
What is the swine? What is the swine, brother? What's another word for swine? It's a pig. Not a pig. So God is telling you that a pig, even though it has certain features that appear to be clean, it doesn't have the proper digestive system. Therefore, it is unclean to you. God even goes as far as to say it's an abomination to you. An abomination means something disgusting. Okay? God says don't eat it, don't even touch it. Understand it? Give me Leviticus 19 and 27, please. Somebody, brother, what's up? 19, hold that, please.
Leviticus 19,
verse 27.
And verse 27.
You know.
Ye shall not round the corners of your head.
You shall not round the corners of your head.
Neither shalt thou mar the corner of thy beard. You shall not make any cuttings in your flesh.
So what's that first part? So you should not round the corners of your head. No baldness. So you can't cut your head off bald. So you can't shave your hair off. Understand? That's against the commandment. And you should not mar the corners of your beard. That means you cannot cut your beard. Let it grow.
Right.
Those are two more commandments, right?
Yes. And you shall not make any cuttings in your flesh for the dead. Nor print any marks upon you.
What does that sound like to you? No cutting yourself and no prints. What's a print? No tattoo. Good for
right.
You, dog. So that's the four commandments right there. Right?
Give me Exodus 20 and 8.
Exodus chapter 20 and verse 8. Remember the Sabbath day.
Remember the what?
Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God.
Brother, what day is today? What day is today? What day is that? What number day? It's the seventh day? 1 through 7. What day are we at? Seventh day. So today is the Sabbath day.
Genesis chapter 1.
So what did it say? On the Sabbath day, you want to keep me one more time.
Remember the Sabbath day.
Remember the Sabbath day, which is today.
To keep it holy.
Keep it holy.
6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work.
6 days, you have 6 days to work and do whatever you want to do. Right? Sunday through what? Through Friday. Alright? But the seventh day
is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God.
It's special to God. Okay? Now let's see when the Sabbath day starts. Genesis chapter 1 verse 5. I'll let you start.
Genesis chapter 1 and verse 7. And God made the firmament and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament. And it was so. And God called the firmament heaven. Verse 5. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning were the first day.
And the what?
And the evening and the morning were the first day.
So when does the day start? The evening and the morning was the first day. When does the day start? At the evening. So when the sun goes down, the day starts. So when do you believe, based upon what we read, when does the Sabbath day start? Almost had it. So which day is the Sabbath day? The stars win. So Friday sunset is a new day, right? So when the sun goes down on Friday, it's the Sabbath day. The seventh day, right? So when does the Sabbath end? 24 hours. So it starts sunset Friday night. When do you think it ends? Remember, the day starts, it ends, according to Genesis 1:5, at evening. Right? So when do you believe the Sabbath is over? Saturday evening, right? The sun goes down, right? So it starts Friday evening and it ends Saturday evening. All right? Sisters, let me talk to you real quick. 5 minutes. 5 minutes.
Come on.
1 minute. All right? All right, sisters, let me ask y'all, what is your nationality?
Your nationality. What's your race?
Like you're black.
Black. Do I look black? You don't look black.
So let's be specific.
I mean, come on, let's give it 100.
All right, the 100. We the human race. You say give you 100, we're going to give you 100.
So do I look like that sister over there? I'm sorry, that woman over there?
You do. Like your pigmentation is different, but you
there
do.
There you go, so I'm not her, right?
That's correct.
Right?
That's correct. Give me Deuteronomy 7. We'll talk about this.
You want to go to the Old Testament?
Hold on a second. Give me 1 Peter 2 and 9. We'll deal with this right,
okay.
Right here. Matter of fact, you don't believe in the Old Testament?
Absolutely. Oh, that's the foundation.
This is the book of Deuteronomy.
That's correct.
Chapter 7 and verse number 6.
Bring it out.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
We are what?
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
We are holy people.
The Lord thy God have chosen thee.
He's chosen us.
To be a special people.
A special people.
Unto himself.
Unto himself.
Above all people.
Above all everybody.
Above all people.
We're equal with the white man.
Above all people.
We're equal with the Asian man.
Above all people.
God said we're above all people.
That are upon the face of the earth.
We? Israel. We,
right.
You, I, her, we're Israelites.
So.
Right.
So
we're not the human race.
So right. From Jacob. He changed his name to Israel.
Right.
And through the tribe of Jacob, the nation of people come forth as God's specific chosen people.
That's right. That's
the
us.
Israelis.
That's us.
But you cannot denigrate the grace of God who grafted in Gentiles,
well,
who made us equal.
Let's see about that.
Yes, exactly. You can't change that.
It's the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32 and verse 8.
Bring it up.
When the Most High divided to the nations their inheritance.
The Most High did what?
When the Most High divided to the nations their inheritance. When he separated the sons of Adam, he set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel.
You see that?
So why are you associating yourself with the children of Israel?
Because we are the children of Israel.
Right.
Give me a proof. Do we need to prove it?
No, I'm asking you specifically, how are you the descendant of Abraham?
Let's bring it up.
No, you.
He's asking the descendant of Abraham.
Yes. How are you all bloodline?
And then,
on top of that, where is you guys stand on the fact that we are under grace dispensation right now? But you stick it. You stick
it.
No.
How do we know we're the Israelites? You're about to answer your first question.
Yeah. You guys.
Hold on. You got to bow your head on it. Be quiet.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 15.
Bring it out.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God,
right,
to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Okay, I'm going to jump to it.
Now, Paul.
No, answer your question.
I know, but one thing y'all failing to realize.
You can't just thrust
what you're feeling.
You asked us. Then you can ask the second question.
Verse 48. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
These are the curses, right?
Which the Lord shall send against thee, in hunger, and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in want of all things. And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he have destroyed thee.
Who was in the yokes of iron? What race of people were in yokes of iron?
Black folks.
Okay, that's us.
Verse number 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
To where again?
Into Egypt again.
What does Egypt mean, bro? What does it mean? Dollar bill.
Okay, look. I don't, listen. One thing, I'm with family. I stopped in the tank.
Okay.
But let me just get a point across.
We're almost done.
One thing for sure, people.
We're going to grace.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Brother, listen. On the back of the dollar bill is a pyramid, right? Remember that? An Egyptian pyramid, yes or no?
If the rapture was to happen right now, who's going
answer
away?
Answer my question, brother.
Who's going away? I don't have the time to dialogue.
I'm asking you.
The answer to your first question.
Because y'all are skipping something.
The Lord said a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
Okay. You want to answer, then you need to listen.
Where y'all going to be at next?
We got you.
That way I can have a dialogue with you.
There we go. He got to go. Take it this way.
I do. Look.
You see this?
I got
the rapture. Which is the rapture? Take it this way. I'm 4-6.
That's correct.
Go with the rapture.
Mm-hmm. I just wanted to give y'all some time since nobody giving y'all time.
We don't need time. We're here for y'all.
Okay, but y'all hear me because I'm saved by grace. I'm saved by grace. You're not here for me. I'm saved by grace.
What is grace?
The grace of God.
What is grace? That's the gift of God given to mankind through Christ Jesus. That's what grace of God is. That's what grace is. What is grace?
I just told you. It's the gift of God given to mankind through Christ Jesus.
Who is grace for?
is for anybody that ain't saved.
Y'all, all right, hold on, brother.
We're in the new covenant.
Galatians 4:4
We got you.
We're gonna answer a question about grace.
Okay, then we go.
Who is grace for?
Grace is for all mankind.
This is what the Bible says.
Yeah, see what it says.
The book of Galatians chapter 4 and verse 4.
Bring it out!
But when the fullness of the time was come, God sent forth his son.
Who's that?
Jesus. Okay. Made of a woman. Made under the law.
Under the law.
To redeem them that were under the law.
Redeem who?
To redeem them
that were under the law.
What did the scripture say, brother? Read it again, brother.
To fulfill.
To redeem them.
To redeem them
that were under the law.
Who was under the law, brother?
Keep reading.
And who rejected?
Who was under the law?
Who rejected?
The same people.
Who was under the law?
Everybody was under the law. Everybody was under the law. Let's see. Let's see.
Moses. Everybody was under the law. The Jews. If you're a believer in Moses' doctrine,
let's see what the Bible says.
In verse 19.
Here we go.
He showed his words unto Jacob.
His
statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He have not dealt so with any nation.
He's dealt so with no other people.
Right.
You're a liar, brother. Get out of here. Proverbs 28:1. We're going out of here. Proverbs 28:1.
Look it out.
The wicked flee when no man pursueth. But the righteous are as bold as a lion. With that, Yahweh, hold on, Yahweh, Shem Yahushua. Kum Yahshua.
Death to America. The book of Mark, chapter 1, verse number 15.
Bring it up.
And say, the time is fulfilled. And the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe in